Republican Senator Lindsey Graham has finally agreed to be served with the subpoena from the Fulton County prosecutors. Fannie Willis and her team, of course, as we all know, had subpoenaed multiple different individuals recently. Lindsey Graham was one of them. And before the subpoena could ever even be handed to him, because as of right now, it has not been handed to him, he has not been served, he filed a legal challenge in South Carolina saying, "You cannot do this to me." Well, after Fannie Willis went to the court and said, "Hey, there's lots of problems with Lindsey Graham's objection to the subpoena. First and foremost, he wasn't served. So you can't actually challenge something that hasn't happened. And secondly, why is he challenging it here in South Carolina when this is a subpoena for an investigation in Georgia?" Right? He didn't even pick the right venue, Willis argued to the court, successfully, I might add, that he filed it in the wrong place. So Lindsey Graham has decided to drop his current challenge and has agreed to be served with the subpoena. Now, a lot of people have seen this story and said, "Oh, great, so Lindsey Graham's going to go and talk to the prosecutors." Hold your horses, folks. He hasn't agreed to do anything other than receive the subpoena, right? He has agreed to be served. He still retains his right, and by all accounts, it seems like he is going to continue to fight this subpoena. So once he gets served with it, then those arguments made by Fannie Willis, one, you hadn't been served, two, you're doing it in the wrong venue, those become moot, and then he can go to Georgia, challenge the subpoena, and of course, try to put the whole thing off, which I think is the situation we're gonna be dealing with once again, he gets that subpoena in his possession. So this is not Lindsey Graham agrees to go and talk to the grand jury and tell him all the dirty secrets. No, this is just Lindsey Graham agreeing to a formality so that he can continue his legal challenge, which, as I've already mentioned, has no basis in reality to begin with. Like, Lindsey Graham's not going to win this legal challenge. And he knows that. But winning is not necessarily the point. The point is to delay it as long as humanly possible. Lindsey Graham does not want to go talk to those prosecutors, but he understands there's probably a 99% chance that eventually he will have to. But the longer he can delay it, the more he can kind of work his story out. But a word of caution to you there, Lindsey. You might be challenging the subpoena, but there's plenty of other individuals that are not. There's plenty of other individuals that have already talked to the grand jury that have information about things that you said to them. So the longer you wait, the worse the situation could become for you. Because if this grand jury builds up this trove of information of bad things Lindsey Graham may have done, and then you go to the grand jury 6 months from now, sit down, finally talk to them after you lose your court battles, and you tell them something different, because you don't know what everybody else already said because they've already testified and moved on with their lives, you could then be looking at perjury. So the choice is yours, Lindsey. Either all your friends are going to talk and you're going to be last to the party, not knowing what kind of information they gave about you, or you can go ahead and man up and just talk to the damn grand jury because you're not even part of the criminal probe. They're not looking to charge you with anything. They're just looking for information. But for some reason, you're too scared to give them that information. And eventually, we're going to find out why.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.